gang. Welcome to another episode of Value Added, the Real Estate Podcast. On today's show, we're chatting with Sam Weiner. Sam is a New York City-based vice president with Langdon Title, a title insurance company here in New York. He is also a graduate of the Kelly School of Business at University of Indiana. So without further ado, let's get on with the show.
Welcome to Value Added, the real estate podcast where we speak with the brightest minds in the world of real estate who provide, create, and realize value in an ever-changing market. And now your host, Nick Walters.
Well, are you buried under all the snow down there in the city?
You know, it's really not that much snow anymore. I mean, it kind of all evaporated. Sorry, but I think we're supposed to get a lot of snow this week. So,
yeah.
Where are you located again?
I'm in the Connecticut suburbs. So okay. I lived in the city for 15 years, and I know that 3 inches of snow means it translates to about a foot and a half of snow in the suburbs. So
yes, exactly.
I know how bad it is with just a dusting.
Yeah, I was born and raised in Long Island, so I definitely know what you're talking about.
Yep, absolutely. So let's get right into it. Tell the listeners a little bit about yourself and Langdon Title and how you got to where you are today.
Exactly. Awesome. Well, first, I do want to say thank you for having me. To give everyone just a brief synopsis of myself, I'm Samuel Weiner. I'm born and raised in a town called Roslyn. It's in Nassau County on Long Island. From there, I went to Indiana University. I was a direct admit into the Kelly School of Business. I was a dual major in business management and international business. I would say best 4 years of my life, go Hoosiers. From there, I knew I wanted to move back to Manhattan, move to Manhattan upon graduation. I wasn't exactly sure which industry was for me yet, but I knew based off of my interpersonal communication skills, I wanted to be in some type of sales and business development opportunity. So I networked around and I got in touch with somebody who was from the same area as me, who was a director at a staffing and recruitment firm. And I ended up accepting an opportunity before graduation there to start right after I graduated. So I started my career at a company called Sony Resources Group. They're a staffing and recruitment agency based out of Manhattan. I focused more on the business development initiatives of the firm. So getting corporations and companies to use the firm's recruitment services. I did a little headhunting, but mostly in the jobs I brought in to double side the commission, as you could imagine. So, and it was good. I mean, I gained a lot of great skill sets in sales, business development, recruitment, got a great understanding of different industries, sectors, because I did position myself as a total solution provider, giving me the ability to really work on any type of opportunity that came to us. And all was well. I was probably there for about 8 to 10 months, but you know, I mean, just from the people that surrounded myself from growing up when I was starting my professional career in school, I've always had an underlying passion to be in the real estate realm. So I went to one of my closest family friends who owns his own commercial real estate firm. And I said to him, listen, based off of who I am, I'm interested in starting in my real estate career. What do you suggest for me? And he gave me two suggestions. One was brokerage. The second one was title insurance. And I said to him, you know, I know a lot of brokers. I know a lot of agents. Great industry. What the F is title insurance? I literally never even heard of the term I was 23 at the time, in all my 23 years. He gave me a brief synopsis. He said, let me introduce you to my title guy. Happened to introduce me to the principal of my firm at Langdon. We went out for dinner. Luckily, this was all before the pandemic. And right when I walked in, he said, you know, I spoke to XYZ. They gave me good reviews. Let's start eating. And I was like, wait, those are like my best friends growing up. It happened that the principal actually moved to Roslyn, where I'm from. He's probably 15 years older than me, 15 years younger than my parents, but he knew a couple people from the neighborhood who luckily had good things to say about myself. So, you know, immediately after there, we had that connection and I ended up accepting an opportunity in late January, early February, right before the pandemic. You know, so I've been with Langdon Title for about a year and a month now. I am vice president of sales and business development. Langdon Title is a national title insurance firm. We're based out of Manhattan. We also have small offices in New Jersey and Long Island as well. We focus on all real estate transactions, both residential and commercial. We also assist in refinances and loans of all sizes. I know we're going to probably get a little bit into it, but you know, title insurance for everybody listening is a very lucrative sector of real estate. It's pretty much, I would say, a mandatory part of every single time you're purchasing and refinancing a property. So my job in the business development sector is to really build relationships with real estate professionals to be that focal point of communication and make sure we're providing the best service, quickest turnaround time, and that we're being value adds and beneficial to return the favor. So that's the overall background of myself.
Cool. So let's dig deeper into what title insurance actually is. I'm throwing you a lob shot here. What exactly is title insurance as it relates to the real estate industry?
Yep. So title insurance, by definition, it's really a way to protect yourself from financial loss and related legal expenses in the event there is a deficit in title to your property that is covered by the policy. Let's put it in simpler terms. It protects buyers from past events. So it's actually not the opposite, but very different from home insurance, life insurance, health insurance, in that those you're paying premiums to protect you against future events. Title insurance protects you against past events. So we go through the property past 5, 10, 15, 100 years, make sure there's no liens, encumbrances, really any issues, so that there's a clear transfer of the title from the old ownership to yourself. All title issues are resolved by the completion of closing. So right when the contract gets put in place, usually we're the next step to come in, whether 60 days, 90 days, 120. However, in that due diligence period, we make sure that all issues are resolved before closing. You only purchase title insurance once. So during closing, you pay a one-time premium, and then you're insured for the entire time of your ownership. And as I said, yeah, that's valid for the entire ownership. So I think that was a good synopsis for now.
That's a very good synopsis. What is the most common cloud on a title report?
So I would say by cloud, you mean issues, I'm assuming, correct?
Issue, item, yep.
Yeah. So first I would say is lien searches, where we're uncovering any tax liens or mechanics liens, make sure no taxes or money's owed. We do a lot of mortgage searches, which is uncovering outstanding mortgages and money owed towards past ownership. Judgment searches, which is more like pending litigation and legal issues with past property owners. And a lot of it is encumbrances. So restrictions, easements, encroachments, making sure that your driveways at your property, your fences is exactly where they should be, not 5 yards onto your neighbor's, 5 yards into yours. Those are like more of the more common issues that we come upon.
What is the main function for having title insurance, and how does it relate to the ownership of the property, whether it be a single family home or a piece of commercial real estate?
Yep. So can you repeat the first part of the question again? Sorry.
What's the main function of the title of a piece of property?
You know, I like to like put it in one sentence. You might laugh. I like to say, so nobody could ever knock on your door and say, this isn't your property. You know, I mean, title insurance is, we do all the way from single family residential homes all the way to commercial transactions, whether multifamily, hospitality, retail, any different asset class, making sure that, you know, this is your asset, that you know every single function about it, past issues, everything's clear, and that you could really make sure you're following the rules and that everything goes smooth with this purchase and that, or refinance of any of type, and that it's all, that there's no, you don't have to worry about something happening from a past event, that it's all clear and you're ready to move on. It's your asset. So that's like the main function, I would say.
If you have a buyer or an investor, in most cases, I would assume it's the legal team reaching out to you to engage your services to go into due diligence of a particular transaction.
Yeah, we work very closely. Oh, sorry.
I was just going to ask, when does it happen? When are you called? And walk us through kind of your role from that first point of contact.
So we are contacted usually when the executed contract is put in place. Sometimes before, if the buyers and sellers and the real estate attorneys, because you are correct about the legal process, especially on the residential end, we usually work hands on hands with the real estate attorney assigned to the transaction, or if it's a lender, the mortgage banker, the mortgage broker, etc. But regardless of that, right when the contract is executed, usually we're contacted as soon as possible. So we have as much time as possible before closing to make sure everything is resolved. From there, we partner with all the major underwriters. So then we would speak to the underwriters, make sure we're picking the best underwriter of choice to assist us in underwriting the deal. And then, you know, our back end staff, all our different departments and teams that focus on all the different, whether it's closing, escrow, settlement, our legal team, a lot of our back end staff is attorneys themselves, you know, just making sure everything's clear. And then we hopefully can get the title report to you as soon as possible. It takes longer on the larger transactions, I would say. So more commercial would take a little longer than a residential deal or a condo, co-op, et cetera. And then, as long as you get the title report, we make sure with all different parties of the deal, the buyer, the seller, the attorneys, the lenders, everybody involved, that everybody's clear to go. We have a closer attend the closing and you're ready to go. So
walk me through a transaction. This can be a hypothetical transaction. This can be a transaction that you've worked on in the past. But let me kind of give you an example. So I just signed a contract to buy a piece of property, and you are brought into the deal, and there is a mechanics lien on the property from some renovations that were done, and a carpenter or general contractor filed a mechanics lien against the property because he wasn't paid at all or in full. So walk us through how that process is resolved on your end in teaming up with the rest of the team members of the transaction.
Yeah. I'm more on the external sales side, so I don't get too much involved in the actual back end of how this is handled. But what
instead of bringing you into a question that is not really your world, can you give us some sort of timeline or just the general process in how these liens are erased from the title report? Can you give us some sort of color onto just the very, very top level general process?
And that's what I was going to say. So I'm the focal point of communication, usually from the buyer and outside party to the internal staff at Langdon. So really, I mean, timeline usually doesn't take too long. I mean, we work with the underwriters and obviously the past ownership and past prior title policies, whether we could find the attorneys on the deal, really everybody that was involved in that transaction, and really making sure that everything is handled ASAP so that there's no push back in terms of closing date. That's really why I was saying that we like to come in as soon as everything's executed in terms of the contract, so that we have enough time to make sure, just in case this mechanic lien comes up, we have that 30-day, 60-day, 90-day, however long in terms of closing, to make sure that all these issues are resolved. Nothing can really come back the week of before closing and say, hey, we actually still have to do this. And then we have to say to the client that we have to push closing back. We're not ready to close yet. So, you know, I mean, there's no definite timeline, but from my year and so being in the industry, I know Langdon, for example, does a very, very good job of really, if finding any issues, if any, establishing all sources that they need to contact and made aware about the situation, and that everything could be resolved in a short amount of time. And really, for me, it's more making sure that the buyer and the outside parties understand about this issue that arises. Sometimes they don't even need to know. If it's a very small lien, you know, I mean, if it's, we could handle it in a couple days or so, you don't even want to put a worry on them. But for me, it's keeping the transparency to them, letting them know everything will be handled by XYZ. You should probably receive your title report by XYZ. This is when we're planning on close. Well, they're the ones who provide closing date, but we should be all cleared with all documents from here on. And actually, just to add upon that, I know it's a little separate from the question, I actually just completed my notary exam last week. So now I believe I passed. I haven't heard back yet, but I shouldn't see it being an issue. So now I'm going to train for title closing so that I could really be, because usually once the closing step process, I'd say thank you. If you have any other deals or anything I could help, let me know. Now I could go all the way, attend the closing, and then really be that next step as well. So
cool.
I hope that answered to a good.
Yeah,
good,
absolutely. That was very helpful. Now, is bringing a title company into the transaction, is it absolutely necessary that a title company is brought in to handle the title insurance and researching the history, or can this be done by an internal legal team?
Depends on states. Every state has different.
So let's talk about New York specific.
New York specifically, a title insurance firm has to be brought onto the deal. There's two different policies. An owner's policy is when you're purchasing the property yourself. Lender's policy is required by the lenders, banks, when you're refinancing a property, as you could imagine. Lenders require it to make sure that they're safe in terms of lending, obviously, out the asset. Purchasing, I mean, 99% of the time. So yes, it's pretty much required in New York State.
Have you or any other your other team members found yourself as providing more value to a buyer of commercial real estate or another part of the world, providing more value than just researching a title report? For example, I have a very good contact of mine that is in the title world in the city in New York. But through his network, he has very good access to potential off-market deals. You know, I'm sure that you can. I'm sure that you have access to additional deal flow that also might be an additional value add to your network of buyers of real estate. Is that accurate?
I was waiting for this question. Just to go into the background because of that, just which is very true, is that title insurance is pretty much a fixed price overall. So yes, companies could add some ancillary fees, but the overall one-time premium you're going to pay is identical across the board for all title insurance firms, especially in New York. So it's very important for us to be a value add and beneficial to our clients, additional to exceptional service and quick turnaround time. My number one value add is giving my clients and relationships access to my large network of real estate professionals. I have access and relationships with real estate professionals in all different asset classes and sectors, not only in New York, but really all across the country from a residential standpoint all the way to a large commercial standpoint. And yes, I do have access to off-market deals. I like to keep my off-market deals all commercial, just so it makes sense for all parties. Residential, I stick that with the agents, but I do have a lot of agent and broker relationships and all across the country. So just being giving access deal flow to buyers across the country as well. So it's cool. Very important for us to figure out different value adds.
Great. This was all super, super helpful. You know, title is one of those necessary evils in the world of real estate, but it is very, commonly overlooked, or people will downplay the importance of really digging into the history of a particular property. So we really appreciate the info that you've brought and the knowledge that you've brought to the table. We're gonna close out this episode with the hard hitting questions. These are the questions that I ask every one of our guests. The first question I always ask is, "What is your why, Sam?"
You know, my why is, I want to make my family, you know, happy and proud of me, of everything I accomplished, my friends, everyone surrounded by me. As you can see, I'm a go-getter. I like to consider myself a hustler. So, you know, it's very important for me not only to be successful, but to enjoy every single day and, you know, live the best life I could live. So,
is there a recent book or another piece of media that you've consumed that has provided significant value to your life, whether it be professional or personal?
You know, I mean, I'm just to be honest, not the biggest reader myself. I'm more of a speaker. So, you know, what I like to do is I like to reach out to colleagues, business partners, any type of relationship I have, and just pick their mind. I mean, get any type of knowledge I can get of anything going on in the world. I mean, I've definitely been very involved recently in more of the stock market. There's a boom there. So just getting more educated on not only the real estate markets, but all the markets across the country. So,
you're not too far removed from your college days, but knowing what you know now, what would you tell yourself, your 20, 21, 22 year old self, postgraduate, you know, what would be your number one piece of advice?
My number one piece of advice would be to network and keep your mind open. I graduated college. I didn't know exactly which industry and sector I wanted to be in. I didn't even know the word title insurance existed. And, you know, I'm very happy in my current role, and I see myself being in the industry for a very, very long time. So, you know, in terms of college, work hard, play hard. And then after that, you know, network with as many people as possible. And, you know, great opportunities will arise themselves. So
how can our listeners get a hold of you or learn a little bit more about you and Langdon Title?
Yeah, I mean, I would just say the best way to reach out to me is if you go to my LinkedIn page. I have all my contact information there. Anybody can reach out to me, whether email, my cell phone, at any time. I keep myself available 24/7.
Sam Weiner, we really appreciate the time. Super grateful that you're able to come on and share your knowledge with us. And thanks for adding your value today. Greatly appreciate it.
Thank you for having me, Nick. It was a pleasure.
Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed this episode, please make sure to leave a rating and a review, which will help us introduce the podcast to other listeners. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, which will give you access to other episodes you may have missed. Lastly, if you'd like to learn more about investing alongside us, then head on over to valueaddedpodcast.com. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you next week.